Good morning, church family. It is Friday, May the 8th, and I hope you are doing well today. I'm excited to bring you the devotion today from God's Word and to hopefully talk to you about, again, not being afraid and to fear not, and to let you know that God is still in control and He always will be in control. Today's passage, actually today's devotion, comes out of 2 Chronicles chapter 20. Verses 15 through 17. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verses 15 through 17. And it's, I got to kind of set it up. King Jehoshaphat is just talking to them about this army of Moab and Ammon that they're about to go battle against. And what is happening is he has just given this dissertation, this speech, and about the power of God and how God's going to protect them. And then it says, the Spirit of the Lord came on Jehazel, son of Zechariah. And what I'm going to read is actually what Jehazel says to the people, to the kingdom there. And this is what, after the Spirit of the Lord came on Jehazel, this is what he says to the kingdom, to the assembly there. And he says this in verse 15, it says, he said, "Listen, King Jehoshaphat and all who live in Judah and Jerusalem, this is what the Lord says to you. Do not be afraid or discouraged because of this vast army. For the battle is not yours, but God's. Tomorrow march down against them, and they will be climbing up by the pass of Ziz, and you will find them at the end of the gorge in the desert of Jerel. You will not fight this battle." Now listen to that. "You will not have to fight this battle. Just take up your positions, stand firm, and see the deliverance of the Lord will give you Judah and Jerusalem. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. God will face them tomorrow, and the Lord will be with you." I find it fascinating that there's a couple of "do not be afraids" in here, but it says, and I'm just going to read, "Do not be afraid or discouraged because of this vast army. The battle is not yours, but God's." And then it says, "You will not have to fight this battle. Just take up your positions and stand firm." Just do what you are supposed to do. Take up your positions and stand firm. God is fighting this battle for you. He will fight the battle for you. Do not be afraid or discouraged. Go out to face them tomorrow morning or tomorrow, and the Lord will be with you. And basically, and I think I've said this before in one of our devotions, but it's so evident here and it's so truthful here. God is wanting us to do what we can do, what, you know, just, He wants us to take up our positions, as it says in this verse. But the truth is, God is fighting the battles that we do not see. God is doing things that we do not see, and we probably never will see. But as long as we are faithfully following Him, God is fighting the spiritual battles for us, and He is fighting those battles constantly, day in and day out, for us. And I believe that because the scripture says that happens here, and I believe that God still does that today, that He fights your battles for you in the spiritual realm. And it's our responsibility, no matter how hard taking up the position is, as it says here, take up your position, no matter how hard taking up the position is, no matter how hard the responsibility is that we're supposed to do, and standing firm in the faith, we're supposed to do that, but God is doing His part in the heavenly realms and fighting the spiritual battles that we do not see. And He will fight the battle for us. And so I just want to encourage you with that. Don't be afraid. Don't be discouraged because of whatever you see in front of you, because of the, you know, in this scripture it says the vast army. Don't be afraid or discouraged of what you see in front of you. God is fighting the battles for us in the spiritual realm that we do not see. And it is His battle that we're fighting. And so I just want to lift you up and encourage you today. I hope you're doing well. Let's pray. God, I just thank you for this beautiful day, the cool weather this morning. God, I thank you for the sunshine. and the love that you give to us. God, I want to thank you for the grace and mercy that comes through Jesus. And Lord, I praise your name for the fact that you are fighting the battles for us that, in things that we do not see and we will never probably see. But yet, God, we're supposed to be responsible for what we can do, God, and take up the position, God, and stand firm in our faith. But God, you fight the battles that we can't see. You fight the battles that we can't fight. And Lord, we just praise you for that. Lord, I love you. I thank you for this opportunity to be together with my church family, and we want to honor you in Jesus' name. Amen. Church family, I love you. Can't wait to see you. And remember, always get into God's truth. I hope and pray that you're growing closer to him during this time. And then get into God's truth. And then as always, in Christ Jesus, there is hope. I love you. God bless you. Have a great day. See you tomorrow.